This is the most clear.
And we're not going to call it religion. It's the way. It's the way to get to who? Allah. I want to be with Allah in the next life. And really, I want that for everybody here. I do. But the only way we can get there is to do it on His terms. I cannot make up a religion and expect Him to accept it. Can I? Can I go out into the bush, pull up some trees, carve them up into some kind of little statue, and start praying to those little sticks and stones and asking them to help me? Can I do that? Physically, you could do it, but would it work? Duh. How is a stick going to help me when I was just cutting it a minute ago and he couldn't help himself? Some people, by the way, carry a lucky rabbit's foot. I don't know if you have that in Australia or not. Do you have that? Lucky rabbit's foot? Have you ever heard of that? Very popular in Texas when I was growing up. Lucky rabbit's foot. They get their foot, put it on a little chain, wear it around their neck, put it on the keychain. You ever heard of that? Wasn't very lucky for the rabbit, though, was it? Gotta think about that. I saw somebody who was a driver, a taxi driver. He had a little statue. In India, he had a little statue in front of the steering wheel. When I got in the car and shut the door, the little statue started to wiggle. I said, "What is that?" He said, "That's my God." I said, "That's God?" He said, "Yep." He said, "But that's only one God." I said, "Okay." He said, "That's the God for driving around, the traveling God." I said, "You know, when I slammed the door, I noticed he wiggled a little bit. If you're a traveling God, you better put a seatbelt on him. Otherwise, he's going to fall on the floor. You have a problem." What's amazing is his comment back to me, because I'm playing with him a little. You know, I just, what if it falls on the floor? What if it breaks? He said, "I'll just go buy another one." Besides, he smiles, reaches over and grabs it. It has Velcro on it. So you can make up a God with Velcro on it. You can go out and cut up sticks and stones and play around. But do you really think that's going to benefit you? Who created everything? Who created the heavens and the earth? And you ask the people, and they'll say, "Allah, God." And who created the sunset? Who created colors and beauty? Who created you? They'll say the same thing, God. Is that right? You haven't said it. So the question becomes, then why don't you want to worship Him in His terms? Why do you want to make up a religion? Good question. Having said that, introducing the subject and giving you the meaning of the words that I'm going to be using, I think it's time that we start up now and tell you the story about priests and preachers entering Islam. First of all, Muslims should always begin whatever they do with Bismillah, with the name of Allah. But there are a lot of people that say they believe in one God, but what do they believe? And I'm going to change the subject a little bit. Suppose we're going down the road, you know? Maybe, as an example, we wanted to drive from here to Perth. Would that be a trip? That'd be a trip, wouldn't it? So as we're going along in the middle of nowhere, all of a sudden we see somebody out there hitching a ride. So we say, "Wow, man, look at this guy out here in the middle of nowhere. Let's give him a ride, you know?" And then we'll share the message of Islam with him, and who knows what will happen. We'll call it da'wah. Give him the invitation, right? So we slam on the brakes, he gets in the car, you know, "Hey, where are you going? We're going to Perth." "Where else are you going to go?" "So the road only goes one way." "Okay, so here we go." And along the way, we say, "You know, we're Muslims." He goes, "Really? I heard stuff about you guys in the newspaper, news and stuff, you know? What do you guys believe?" "We believe in one God." He said, "Me too, man. No joke, yeah." He said, "I only believe in one God." "Hey, cool. It's almost a Muslim already." "But we believe that he's really one." He said, "Yeah. We don't believe he's three." "No, no, 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 I'm a one guy." "One. One God. Okay. Oh yeah, and we believe that you have to do what God wants you to do. He goes, yeah, that's what I think too. We're going, hey, that's it. Far as I'm concerned, he's a Muslim. Give me shahada. Shahada la ilaha illallah, shahada Muhammad Rasulullah. And takbir Allahu Akbar, takbir Allahu Akbar, takbir Allahu Akbar. Now that's it, give me Quran, that's done. But along the way he said, stop the car, stop the car. Whoa. We stop the car and he runs out in the desert. But there's this huge tree. Nothing else out there but this huge tree. Huge. He runs up in front of that tree and he's standing there like this and bowing down on the ground of this tree. What is that? Could be a sutra. Could be. He comes back. We go, what is that? What did you just do? He said, we believe in God.
Yeah.
Worship one God.
Yeah.
We do what God wants us to do.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He said, well, that was God. I was saying thanks. Oh. Get it? What did he mean when he said it? What was in his mind? What's he trying to say? Some people put God in the creation. Some people put God in the creation. And if they do that, they're always going to come up short. A little later, we're going to go into that and break it down. But now I want to tell you what happened to me. This is how it started. My father was an ordained minister and a businessman at the same time, non-denominational Protestant, just for the record. I also had become a preacher, but I was also a music minister, meaning that I spent a lot of time playing music, selling musical instruments to the church, etc. And one day, Dad came to me and he said, we're going to be doing business with a man from Egypt. I said, hey, good. He said, yeah, we're going to be, you know, importing things and selling them in our store. So that's good, man. Nile River, pyramids, the Sphinx, Abu Hu. Mm-hmm. Cool. He said, yeah, and he's a Muslim. I said, a what? He said, a Muslim. I said, nah, Dad, you know, I wasn't going to have anything to do with it. You know, those guys are terrorists, hijackers, kidnappers. They don't believe in God. They kiss the ground 5 times a day and they worship a black box in the desert. That's what we knew. That's what we've been told. SubhanAllah. Dad said, well, I want you to meet him. I said, no way. He said, you have to meet him. I said, no. Dad said, you will meet him. Now, it's my dad's house, dad's business, and all meeting. But I said, it has to be on my terms. He said, okay, what's your terms? I said, I got to come straight from church. I'm going to come straight from the church, and I'm going to have on my cross, have my Bible, and my cap that said, Jesus is Lord. Dad said, okay. And I'm going to bring my born-again wife with me, and we're going to really pray this man into salvation. He said, okay. We came straight from church on Sunday afternoon, went to my dad's store. And by the way, in the United States, you can be open on Sunday. So we went there. I said, where is he? No, I'm expecting to see some guy in a long, you know, black dress and some kind of what we call a baya over it, or bish, and maybe a big turban on his head, eyebrows that go all the way across from one side to the other, with a big sword. I'm looking for Ayatollah Khomeini. But it surprised me. Dad said, here he is. I went, where? This guy? I'm expecting a big beard. This guy has no hair at all, not even up here. He's bald. And when I shook his hand, I was surprised. It's warm, like a human being. Last week in Sydney, after our program, the daughter of one of the ministers that was there came to us and she said she was so surprised. She said, you guys are human just like us. Wow. I think we need to get a new press agent. We're not doing very good with our PR.
So, I asked him straight up, do you believe in God?
Yeah, but mom,
God.
He said, yes.
I'm talking about the God of Abraham.
He said, yes.
Moses?
Yeah.
David, Solomon?
Yeah.
You believe in the Bible?
Do you believe in the Old Testament?
Yes. Psalms?
Yes.
Yes, but do you believe in the precious name of Jesus?
I said, yes.
Well, this is going to be easy. Yes, sir. I told Dad, let's bring him on. That'll be great. In fact, we got an extra place out at the house. Let him stay with us.
Dad said, don't try to convert him.
I said, what? So I decided that here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to work with this man day and night and witness to him, that's what they call it in Christianity, showing him the Bible until he realizes the truth and he becomes a Christian. Now, along the way, we were working together. I was very impressed with his work ethics. He was a very honorable, honest, and truthful person. Had to admire that in him. Really had to admire it. I couldn't help but notice that it didn't matter what it was, he was always fair to the customer, and unlike some people I knew, he never talked about people behind their back. Usually after a customer, well, I don't know, if you go in a store and you act like an idiot, and you see the clerk is standing there going, no matter what you do, customer's always right. As soon as you leave, what an idiot. He never did that. That was amazing. And driving, our business took us a lot of miles every day. And while we'd be driving across country in Texas, it'd be big. Not as many like you got here, but big. I would engage in certain kinds of debates with him. Amazingly enough, he avoided debates and just kept throwing questions back to me. Just to think. Finally, he told me, you know what? I'm willing to go to your religion. I'm willing to go to your religion if your religion is better than my religion. That's easy. There's no religion in the world easier than Christianity. Is it? All you gotta do is say one thing, and that's it. One thing, you're done. Good to go. Let's start filling up the bathtub. We're going to dunk that boy tonight. We're going to baptize him. But then he threw me a curveball. I don't know where it's coming from. Maybe he watched those cricket players or those rugby guys or something. Man, it come from nowhere. He said, but you're going to have proof. I said, what? Proof? I remember telling him, religion is not about proof. It's about faith. Brother, you know what he said? In Islam, we have both. Proof and faith. And one helps us to get more of the other. I'm going, huh? I can see I need help. I have a friend in those days, another preacher. I have quite a few preacher friends. But this one particular one's pretty well known, at least in our area, because when he feels like, when the Spirit moves him, he takes two huge beams, big wooden boards, bolts them together, carries it on his back like a cross, goes down the highway with this big cross. And then people stop and he gives out these little miniature Bibles. So I went to him and I'm telling him about this and talking about it. And I said, and by the way, he believes in Jesus, the miracle birth, the miracles that Jesus did with people to help them, you know, and heal them and restore.